Welcome to That's Pretty Neat with Rodger and Stefan, where we discuss neat, holistic, regenerative agriculture.
So I just heard a new word really recently, like 5 seconds ago. What is biochar?
Okay, so when people are trying to think how to sequester carbon, a lot of people are saying, well, we should do biochar. And what biochar is basically it's a charcoal. So you take a tree or a shrub, and you burn it. And then when it's kind of burning, then you stop the burning process, and it turns to a charcoal.
Okay.
Then what people have been doing is they're saying, well, let's then bury that underground, and because it's a carbon. It has lots of pores and it creates habitat for microorganisms in the soil. So the thinking was, okay, we can sequester carbon by doing that. However, that is once again, we've taken biological carbon,
yep,
and we've turned it into chemical carbon. Now,
through the process of burning.
Through the process of burning. Then by burying it, we've hoped that, oh, well, now we've sequestered carbon, but technically we've taken the carbon out of the life cycle.
Okay.
Now, anytime we come up with an idea, we look for the unintended consequences of that decision. Now, there's already research that was done in the Amazon 800 years ago, because that is a process that the people there did 800 years ago. And people still today talk about the rich black soils and how good they are. But like anything, we have to analyze it. And what we find is that that carbon from that 800-year-old biochar, what's happening to that is it's breaking down and it's floating down the rivers as one element-sized pieces of chemical carbon. So just like we've got microplastics in the ocean from that carbon that's broken down, we've also got micro biochar floating down the river and into the ocean, no different than the plastics. So we know that the microplastics are bad.
Yeah.
By the same token, we also know that the biochar breaking down 800 years later is also bad. The other thing is you wouldn't want this idea to spread globally. So for biochar in your vegetable garden, in the backyard, a little plot, fantastic, great. It'll really help you out. But it's a good idea on a small scale. It's not an idea that we want globally.
Okay, I got a question. So what would happen if you just buried that wood instead of burning it?
Well, that would actually be better. Yes, if you just buried the wood instead of burning it, you've left it as biological carbon.
Okay.
What would happen then is it would go from the wood carbon to fungi, and animals would then break it down, and it would change forms as a biological carbon, but it would stay sequestered
because it wasn't turned into chemical carbon.
Yes.
Cool.
The point is, you know, that carbon came from photosynthesis in the tree. Yes, it would be better to keep it as biological carbon, but you also have to consider time, money, and energy, and what are the benefits. So that's just my warning to the world that biochar is a nice idea, but it's not an idea that we want to spread. Because we already know what the unintended consequence of that decision will be, and that's a negative.
Keep the carbon alive.
Keep the carbon alive. Yep. It tastes much better as a steak or a piece of lettuce.
Or a banana.
Or a banana. Yep.
You can follow Rodger at d2gftf.com and also on his socials at Rodger Savory Holistic Management on YouTube and Facebook. We are Las Cumbres Ranch. You can follow us on social media at Las Cumbres Ranch over all platforms. And thanks for tuning in.
Let's go.
been real neat.